Welcome to the fourth lesson in this course to help you learn Affinity Photo desktop fast. These lessons are designed to be watched in sequence, so if you haven't seen the earlier ones, you should watch those first. You'll find links to the previous lessons of this course in the YouTube video description below. In this lesson, we look at filters and live filters with the help of the gauge and blur filter. It's vital that you learn how to work properly with filters before trying to understand what you can use the various filters for. Many new Affinity Photo users are confused by filters and their role in photo editing, so let's try to clear that up in this lesson. When we look at the filter menu, you can see there are a few different categories. Each of these includes one or more filters you can apply to an image. Typically, these are used to add an effect to the image. Because of this, it's easy to confuse filters with adjustment layers, but they are different as this example will illustrate. When I add a black and white adjustment layer to the image, you can see that it appears on a separate layer in the Layers Studio panel. I can then turn the layer visibility off and on, as well as change its opacity to control the strength of the effect. Now compare this to what happens when I add a filter. The first difference is that there isn't a black and white filter. The changes I can make using adjustment layers are different to what I can achieve with filters. Because of this, I'll add a gauge and blur filter to the copy background layer instead. Now you can see the filter is blurring the image, and I can control the strength of the effect using the radius slider. But unlike the adjustment layer, the effect isn't applied as a separate layer in the studio panel. Instead, it's applied directly to the pixel layer I had selected. And although you can see it blurring the layer, it hasn't been applied yet. What you're seeing is a preview of what would happen if I did apply the filter. If instead I click the cancel button, it removes the effect from the image. Let's open the gauge and blur filter again, because there are a few more differences I want you to be aware of. The first of these are the different preview modes, which you'll find at the bottom of most filter dialogs. The default is to view the filter's effect on the entire image, but there's also a split screen preview where you can reposition the split, and there's a side-by-side preview which also allows you to scroll around the image. If you want to hide the filter preview, you need to use the visibility option for the layer that you're applying it to. Once you're happy with the filter, click the apply button to make the change permanent. This applies the filter to the pixels of the selected layer, and it's a destructive change. In other words, you can't reopen and change the filter settings. Your changes are permanently locked into the layer that you applied them to. Trying to use the filter a second time applies additional blurring to the image. Let's undo the blur filter now, because there's another important use for filters, which is when editing masks. Masks are used in Affinity Photo to control which areas of a layer are visible in the image. Watch what happens if I try to apply the gauge and blur filter to the black and white adjustment layer I added earlier. Notice that it isn't having any effect on the image. That's because this is an adjustment layer that doesn't contain any pixels, so there is nothing for the filter to blur. Instead, the filter's being applied to the mask of the adjustment layer. And because this mask is an empty white mask, you can't see that it's being blurred. To show you what's happening, I'll create a mask using the rectangular marquee tool to select an area of the image. Now I can invert this area of the layer mask to change it to black by pressing Command and I on my keyboard. If I hold down my Option key and click on the layer, you can now see the layer mask. Where the mask is white, it allows you to see the layer's effect, whilst black hides it. That's why you now see a square of colour in the centre of the image. The black square is hiding the layer. Watch what happens to this area though when I apply the Gaussian blur filter to the layer again. It blurs the edge of the coloured area because it's blurring the layer mask. If we look at the layer mask again, you can see that it now has a blurred edge. This is an important feature of filters because it means we can apply them to layer masks to refine the mask. So far in this lesson, we've been looking at what I call regular filters, but Affinity Photo also has live filters. The live filter layer is a combination of a filter and an adjustment layer. One benefit of using live filter layers is that it's a non-destructive edit. You can find the live filters in the Layers menu, where you can choose to add a new live filter layer. There you will find similar categories and filters to the filter menu, although not every filter is in the list. Let's add a Gaussian blur life filter, as there are some differences that I want to show you. When the dialog opens, you can see that the filter control is the same as the regular filter we looked at earlier. But what we don't have are the different preview comparison modes. We also don't have a cancel or apply button. Instead, if we look at the layers studio panel, we see that there's a new life filter added as a layer. Notice that this live filter is attached to the image layer so that it appears below and slightly inset. Because this live filter is visible as a layer, it means we can turn it off and on to hide or show its effect. When I close the layer dialog, we can still see its effect on the image, but I can continue to show or hide it. When I double click the live filter layer, it reopens the dialog showing the settings I applied. I can then make changes to adjust the filter. In other words, this is a non-destructive change because it doesn't directly affect the pixels of the layer. Something else you'll see in the dialog is an opacity slider because the filter is acting like a layer. Notice that when I move the slider, the opacity slider in the studio panel also changes for the layer. Earlier we looked at an example where we applied a filter to the layer mask. Let's try that again, but this time using a live filter. As before, I'll add a black and white adjustment layer. I'll then select a rectangular area and invert that part of the layer mask by clicking Command and I on my keyboard. You can then see the coloured square area on the image where the mask's hiding the black and white layer. I'll then click on the black and white adjustment layer in the Layer Studio panel to ensure it's selected. Now I can apply a new Gaussian blur live filter. You can see the new live filter below the black and white layer and slightly indented, showing that it's attached. As with the regular filter, it's blurred the layer mask. But because this is a non-destructive edit to the mask, we can adjust the filter settings. Something else that we can do is to add multiple live filters to the same layer. If I add a twirl filter from the distort category, you can see its effect on the mask. And of course, we can turn the filter layers off and on to hide or reveal them. Now let's look at the layer mask itself by holding down the Option key on the keyboard and clicking. This time, unlike when we used a regular filter, the mask doesn't reflect the live filters attached to it. You only see the effect of the live filter in the overall image preview. By now you should understand what filters are, as well as the difference between the regular filter and the live filters. For most editing, it's probably best to use the non-destructive live filters. There are though some filters that don't have a live filter equivalent. One example is the Detect Edges filter, used to find the edges in an image. When you need to create one of these filters, you should create a consolidated image layer first using the keyboard shortcut Shift, Option, Command and E. If you're using a Windows PC, then that's Shift, Control, Alt and E. You can then apply the filter directly to the new layer. One final difference that I want to mention between filters and live filters is that we can move the live filter layers around. All you need to do is click and drag them using your mouse. But to understand why this is important, you need to understand layers, which is the subject of the next lesson in this course. If I've already published that, you'll see the link on screen now and you should watch that next. If not, you might want to investigate some of the filters available in Affinity Photo. One useful filter is the high pass filter, which you can use to sharpen photos, as I explain in this video. Be sure to subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, and please share this video with other Affinity Photo users. I'll see you in the next video.